Philippine prosecutors recommend no bail for the son of Justice Secretary Boying Remulla as he is formally charged for illegal drug possession. Authorities also assure the public there will be no special treatment for Remulla's son. Rafi Santos with the full story.
Prosecutors in Las Piñas City formally indicted Juanito Jose Remulla III on drug-related charges and recommended no bail for the son of Justice Secretary Boying Remulla. According to documents sourced by ABS-CBN from the prosecutor's office, the younger Remulla has been charged with violating Section 11 or possession of dangerous drugs of RA 9165 or the Comprehensive Dangerous Drugs Act of 2002.
Based on the evidence presented to us, we recommended for the filing of a violation of Section 11 of RA 9165, which is possession of illegal drugs. So initially kasi what was filed were charges for Section 4, which is importation of illegal drugs into the Philippines, and also violation of 1401 of the Tariff and Customs Code. So since all the elements of those offenses happened in Pasay City, kita ng opisina namin that the office that has jurisdiction over those offenses is Pasay City. Yung fact na nareceive niya yung parcel here in Las Piñas City and that parcel contained large amounts of illegal drugs, yun yung kinarga namin sa kanya.
According to the inquest resolution, the parcel seized from Remulla arrived on October 4, 2022 and was labeled as hoodie sweater based on the customs examiner's affidavit. The package came from a certain Benjamin Huffman in San Diego, California. Juanito Remulla was named as a consignee of the package with an address in Las Piñas City. A subsequent inspection by the PIDEA and NAIA IADTG revealed dried marijuana leaves inside the package. It was then that the agencies decided to conduct a so-called controlled delivery of the illegal drugs to Remulla on October 11. According to former PIDEA agent and now anti-illegal drugs advocate Jonathan Morales, a controlled delivery is done to pinpoint and arrest the recipient of the illegal drugs.
Ang controlled delivery is to delay yung process. Kasi once na ito sinubject na dun sa confiscation, immediately after confiscation, i-turn over yan dun sa PIDEA Laboratory Service. Ang isang ahente magpapanggap na delivery boy para siya yung magpa-receive mismo dun sa recipient. Para magkaroon ng personal knowledge yung ahente dun sa recipient ng cargo. Importante dahil ikaw yung mag-i-effect ng arrest.
Morales notes the sensitive nature of such an operation means it needs to get the green light from the PIDEA chief itself to proceed. The PIDEA assures no VIP treatment is being accorded to the Justice Secretary's son.
Hindi dapat mabahala ang ating mga kababayan dahil sinisikap po natin pairalin ng rule of law na pantay-pantay.
Meanwhile, the Bureau of Customs says it will coordinate with its US-based counterparts to trace where the drug seized from Remulla came from.
Upon arrival po, ang parcel po ay nasasubject sa X-ray and physical examination. Ngayon po, pag na-detect po ng Bureau of Customs na mayroong illegal na kargamento na pumasok, agad po natin itong kino-coordinate sa PIDEA. Once na ma-test po ng PIDEA at mag-positive po, magkakandak po ngayon ng operasyon ang PIDEA para po sa controlled delivery with the cooperation of other law enforcement agencies. Mm-hmm. In collaboration with them like the USDEA. Mm-hmm. Ginagawa po ng Bureau of Customs yun. So yung collaboration po na ito para po sa mas malalim na investigasyon.
Remulla is currently detained at the PIDEA headquarters in Quezon City while he awaits his court hearing. Rafi Santos, ABS-CBN News.
The Las Piñas Prosecutor's Office also seeking to assure the public there will be no special treatment for the Justice Secretary's son. It insists the Justice Department has no power to intervene in the case.
Even though we are under the Department of Justice, ang ahensya po namin ay National Prosecution Service. So meron po kaming sariling Prosecutor General. The Secretary of Justice has no direct power to intervene dito sa mga kasong ganito. Kasi ang nag-aasikaso po namang gantong cases is the National Prosecution Service at kami po ay isa lang po sa mga local branches.